people that are watching us all over. Wait, pigieni hawa watu makofi. The people that are watching us all over the world, we love you. We celebrate you. If you just joined in, can you share this video and the Lord will bless you. Now, decisions that you need to make 2022. If you have somewhere to write, write. Number one decision that you have to make. Nawe uko hapo unani watch. If you have to write down, write it. I'm going to be very brief. Decision number one, decide to be serious with God. I don't want you to write decide. Nataka uandike, I decide to be serious with God, 2022. Decide to be serious with God. Colossians 3. Decide to be born again this year. This is not the year of negotiations. If you need to see great catch in every area of your life, if you need to see anything great, inua mkono kama una kalamu, Mary amekuja, na msiniwe zaidi ya 10. Inueni mkono. Mary hapa bere. Na yule na hapa. Mary, kuna watu huko umehesabu na watakosa. Na hapa kuna watu wawili. Hapa kuna watu wawili. Bakisha mbili hapa. I hope wengine... Jimmy, chika. Ata aposo wako wanakaramu? Ha. Decide to be serious with God. 2022, don't live double-sided life. Last year, you lived it. And you saw how it began. You saw how it finished. You saw how it ended. Decide to be serious with God. If you want to stay uko, ka uko, wacha kukua fisi. Fisi, alifanya aje? Migubiri huku, moja huku, mwingine huku, mwishowe, alipasuka. Utapasuka hii mwaka, ukijaribu hiyo maisha. Mnaona venye mnacheka? I'm telling you the truth. Eh? Usiwe kinyonga. Ukiingia hapa kanisani wewe ni muhoite. Muhoite kabisa, muhoite. Ukiingia kwa matatu wewe ni mred. Ukienda nyumbani wewe ni blue. Uko na characteristics za church, za home, za kazini. Yani wewe hauko serious na Mungu. Kama umeamua kuokoka, okoka. Kama umeamua kudanganya, danganya kabisa. The other day we were with my mom in spirit, my prophet, Reverend Joyce Karaoke. And she told us, prophetess, if you decide to hate someone, hate them so well until you are written in the Bible like Penina. Penina was written in the Bible not because of anything else, just by hating Hannah. He hated so perfectly. So if you are hating, hate well. Don't hate, hate. Love, love. Hate it completely. If it's a sin, you love it. Love it too well. Do it. Enjoy. If you have decided to be born again, be born again. Enjoy salvation. This is the year you drop the things that you did last year. This is the year you drop gossip. This is the year you drop sexual sin. This is the year you drop any other kind of the sin you did. You drop lies. You cannot live double-sided and you see great catch. They never work together. You want your business to flourish. You have to be pure in that you do in business. Be true in your business. Do clean business. You have to decide this year to be serious with God. Tell your neighbor, be serious with God this year. Mwangalie mwambie, be serious. If last year you were joking with God, this is not the year to joke. There are people on 31st of December, you will show nothing in your life simply because you are not serious with God. Be serious with the things of God. Be serious to come to church. If you are coming to church, come. Don't come today, tomorrow you're not coming. In a month you have attended church twice. Where have you been the other Sundays? If you decide PCC is your church, stay. Wacha kuruka ruka makanisa. Grasshopper spirit ndio imefanya watu wengine last year wamemaliza frustrated. Because you are jumping from one place to another. Be serious with God. Tell your neighbor, be serious with God. If you are coming to church, come and come early. Mambo ya kuingia pale ile mlango saa 5 kamili. Iache last year. Mambo ya kuingia pale saa 4. Iache last year. Imepitwa na wakati. Wacha kukaka na kwamba you are begged to come to church. It is for your own benefit. It is not for me. It does not benefit any bishop or any pastor or any prophet for you to attend church. It is for you. Serve God this year without feelings and emotions. Decide. That is why I'm not talking about resolutions. I'm talking about decisions. This is a decision you need to make, you as a person, minus your prophet, minus people. You do it and you work on it. You say, I have decided 2022, I will be serious with God. If you have a ministry, stop sitting down. It's the high time, 2022, rise and serve God. If you can do ushering, rise and serve God. You can sing, rise and sing. You can play that guitar. Kuna guitar moja mpaka leo, hatujaitoa karatasi. Iko bado kwa bag. Decide. Hata unaweza enda shule, somea hiyo guitar useme, hiyo guitar haitakaa hapo tena, naenda shule juu ya hiyo. Only 1 month, na unajua kucheza guitar. Tell your neighbor, decide to be serious with God this year. Are we in Colossians? Colossians chapter 3. Okay, jana mwambie, be serious with God. Hello? You be serious with God. Women, be serious with God. Men, be serious with God. Drop anything that removed you from God last year. Drop it. Drop it. If you have decided to be born again, be born again. Drop it. If you are dating married men this year, sema nimekata. I have decided to serve God. If you are doing casual sex, stop it and say, this year I remain pure. I don't want to know how, but the grace will be sufficient. If you use lies to survive, if you use sympathy and crocodile tears to survive and people to help you, this year, decide to grow. Wona tufungulie Bible, chapter 3, kuanzia verse 1. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Let's read together so that you can see. Decision number 1. Andika hapo, I decide to be serious with God. Wenye kalamu zimekuja late. Since you have been raised to a new life with Christ, set your sight on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits in the place of honor of God's right hand. Don't humiliate Christ when he's seated there. The Bible says, now you rise, you sit, and you see reality of heaven. Don't mix your life. If you're born again, you're born again. If you're not, you're not. Tuambiane ukweli. Okay, jini mwambia 2022, tuambiane ukweli. Kama ujaokoka, okoka tena. Na kama utaki kuokoka, kaa hivo. Haina haja, unamisi huku na unamisi huku. Do you know there are people, wako hivi na hivi. So, kwa dhambi yako, haenjoy dhambi. Anafanyanga akiwa amejificha. Hello? Kwa Mungu yuko, haenjoy kwa Mungu kwa sababu hajajipeana fully. So, why should you not benefit from one side? Why are you wasting yourself? If you have decided to be on this side, enjoy that side. Enjoy that side. Enjoy the lies. Lie well. Cheat well. Fornicate well. Hello? Steal well if you are stealing. If you have decided, enjoy that part. Because you have decided to be that way. If you have decided to come to God, enjoy the fullness of heavens in your life. Don't live double-sided life 2022. it will not be well with you. The Bible continues saying, think about the things of heaven, not the things of the earth. Continue. For you died to this life, and your real life is hidden with Christ in God. Can you allow you to die this year? Allow Christ to be seen in your life. Allow whatever you were doing last year to die, and accept that God lives in you. Every morning when you wake up and tell God, I kill me, I die, I disappear, so that you will be seen. Desire that every morning. Desire to be serious with God. Give us the next verse. And when Christ, who is your life, hey, is revealed to the whole world, you will share in all his glory. When you live the way God wants you to live, you shall not only benefit you, you will benefit even the people near you, you will benefit the church, you will benefit where you work, you will benefit the company you work for, you will benefit the business you are doing, and the people that are buying from your business, you will benefit the world. Hello, neighbor. Be serious with God. Can you die and let Christ live in you? Mwangalie mwambie, die and let Christ live in you. Hako karo kakudanganya, karo kakusengenya, kakufe, leo kauwe, mwambie Mungu nimekaua. Hako karo kanakuambianga, jaribu tu, hii ni mara ya kwanza, ni mara moja tu utaacha. Kauwe! And I want you to write Colossians 3. Go and read the entire verses all the way to verse 17. Because of time, I will not read the entire, but make sure you read it all the way to verse 17. You shall see what God is saying. Decision number 2 for you to catch greatness, for you to see the great catch. Decide to be transformed. Hey, decide. Say, I have decided to be transformed. Romans 12 verse 1. I have decided to be transformed. Do away with the things that shakes your faith. Do away with disbelief and doubts. Can you desire to be transformed? Let me tell you. Transformation is not contagious. Transformation is not impactful. I cannot impact you with transformation. Transformation, you need to invest in it. You need to allow yourself to learn. You need to allow yourself to be taught. You need to allow yourself to look for information. You need to allow yourself to look for answers. Are we together? Transformation is not physical. It is very spiritual. It is inside. You need to decide, I will be transformed the way I think. I'll be transformed the way I do things, the way I talk. Be transformed. When you will know, Miriam, you are transformed, is the day that we cannot trace your region here on earth, your tribe, your county, your city. You know that you are transformed. When James, I cannot trace where you are coming from. But kuna watu wanaka, vile wametoka Muranga, wanaka umuranga na wako Nairobi. Do you know there are people, Nicholas, you can take to the US, but they are still living in Kangema, Muranga. They are in the US physically. But inside them, wako Muranga. Inside them, wako Kiambu, wako Kakamega. Be you transformed. Decide to be transformed. Your mind. Can you talk to your mind? Tell your mind. 2022, my mind, be transformed. Zuambia 2022. 2022, my mind, I command you, be transformed. 2022, go to school if you have to. Read books. Don't do the same things that you did last year. They never helped you. Allow God to transform you. Allow Holy Spirit to transform your mind, to transform your heart, to transform the way you think. And that is why you see, nowadays people are happy when they are being lied or cheated. That is where they run. But when they are told reality that can transform them, they don't want them. Tell your neighbor, be you transformed. Anasema aje? Anasemaje? And so dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. 2022, give God your body. Hallelujah. Give God your body. 2021, you gave Kamau your body and he was not your husband. Give God your body. 2021, you gave Rachel your body and she was not your wife. Give God your body. 2022. Na venye mmetulia kama maji ya kondani ya mtungi. Unaona venye mmetulia kama maji ya kondani ya mtungi. 2021, si unajua nani ulipea mwili yako? I'm not talking about married people. Si unajua nani ulipea mwili wako? Amuta itikia. Si unajua? 2022, decide to. Make a decision. My body, I give it as a living sacrifice to my God. I gave it to men. They never helped me in anything. I gave it to women. I never got anything. They just added soul ties. They just added soul ties and their problems. Some of you, you gave your body to a certain man. Immediately you lose a job because that man carries that spirit. Some of you, you slept with a woman. Immediately you lost your job because that woman carries poverty and it's what she's adding to you. So last year you made a mistake. 2022, we are still in the morning of the year. Make a decision to give your body to Christ. Make a decision that nobody will touch you. Nobody will kiss you if you're not married. Thank you for those amens. It's a Bible. Let them be a living and a holy sacrifice. Inua mkono moja, sema, Father, I pray that you may help me. I give you my body this year as a holy sacrifice. The kind he will find acceptable. This is true, the way to worship him. Tumiachiliwa neema ya worship hapa. You cannot worship God when you have not given wholeheartedly your body to him. Verse 2 is my verse. Verse 2. Verse 2, the Bible says what? After it talks about the body. Don't copy the behaviors and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you anasema, do not be conformed in the things of this world. Don't do the things of this world, but instead allow God to transform you, to transform you through your mind, the way you think. Allow God, make a decision to be transformed 2022. Make a decision. Tell your neighbor, make a decision. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The Bible says, do not copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you. Inua mkono wako sema, Father, transform my mind. Transform my mind. Transform the way I think. This is the year you allow God to transform your thinking capacity. Start thinking in another way. Miriam, start thinking in a greater way. Wacha kufikiria kama Mkikuyu. Wacha kufikiria kama Muluo. Wacha kufikiria kama Muluya. Wacha kufikiria kama Masai. Anza kufikiria kama Mungu. Be transformed until people cannot trace who you are. Be transformed until people cannot trace through your talking, the way you talk. You know there are people, if they talk, unasema, we, huyo ameongea na hasira. Ni kama ametoka wapi? Eh? Meru. Ni kama ametoka wapi? Kisii. Can you be transformed to a level people cannot trace you. Have you ever heard people say, hey, wanaume wanyeri, wanakuwaga wamekaliwa. Mshesiki watu wakisema hivyo. Hey, wanawake wanyeri, ukioa mwanamke wanyeri, we. Ujua umeoa congestive. Can you be transformed so that people cannot trace you? That is when you know you are transformed. Hata mtu akikukosea, hawezi akatrace which tribe you are coming from. Are we together? There is this narrative that people are saying, you cannot employ a kamba as a house help in your house because wakamba wakona nini? Wakona nini? Ogeni, simunaongeaga. Wakona? Tu wanabaga uchani, wanakujaga na kambutu, wanaficha kwa nyumba yako. That is what God is saying. May you be transformed the way you think. The way you think. Kuna mtu aliniambia, hey, prophetess, unaandika wakikuyu. Mkikuko kwa simu hivi, anakusikiza. Zile vitu zote zako unasema. Anaanza kusambaza, anaanza kuongea na huko. Hey, uogopaji? Nikamwambia, no, I am transformed. I don't think that way. I don't see people that way. That is not what I see people. Who will work for me if I see people that way? If I see a kamba ati ni mchawi, who will work for me? If I see a mkikuyu akona mshenana ni mwizi, who will work for me? If I see a kisi akona asira, who will work for me? If I see a meru akona asira, who will work for you? May you be transformed the way you think, the way you see things this year. May you be transformed in your mind, the way you carry things, the way you carry people, the way you carry your boss, the way you carry your neighbor, the way you carry your church. Can you be transformed? Can you pray for your head? Can you pray for your brains for a few seconds? Tell God, I pray, transformed my mind, transform my mind, transform my thinking, transform my thinking, transform my thinking. Get out of that position you are. You have been so comfortable there. Be transformed and get to the next level. The reason why you are not getting to the next level is because you became comfortable where you are. The reason why you ended last year with a lot of question marks, with a lot of questions in your heart, it is because you refuse to go to the next level. You refuse kuchanuka kiroho. In other words, when I say be, you decide to be transformed, namaanisha chanuka katika mambo ya roho. Be in another level in the spiritual realm. Be in another level. The way, you know, the way you think, the way you see things, can you shift to the next level? Abraham was told by God, I am sending you somewhere. Get out of your father's house. Get out of your mother's house. Get out of your town. Get out of your city to where I'm taking you. And this is what will follow you when you get out. God had to transform the mind of Abraham first. Before he released the blessing, he had to remove the powers of the village in him. He had to remove the powers of his father and his mother, the influence of Geshagi. But some of us here, we still worship God with the influence of our Ushago. Can you be transformed? Desire to be transformed. I said desire to be transformed. Desire to be transformed. Can you shout a better amen? Simseme amen mzuri. Desire to be transformed this year. Miriam desire. God transform my mind. Transform my mind. God could have called Abraham and tell him, I'll give you a great name. I'll give you a great nation. Whoever bless you, I'll bless. Whoever he was able to do that. But he saw, if I bless this man and the level capacity of what he's thinking, he will not be able to carry the blessings. There are blessings waiting for you. Only transformed your mind. There are blessings on the other side. All they are waiting is for you to transform your mind. Are we together? If for you to transform your mind. Abraham was told, now go. I will do this and this. He was given, I think, 7 blessings that God will do in his life. There are blessings waiting for you only when you transform your mind and you start seeing things in another way. Tell God to transform you this year. And that is why in this church, we are called Prophetic City Church, where we equip, empower, and transform lives through the word of God. You cannot be transformed. It is you to work hard. It is you to look for transformation. It is not impactful. It is you to go read your Bible. Read your Bible. Tell God, as I read this Bible, God, may you give me ideas. May you give me knowledge and understanding and wisdom of what I'm doing. May you be transformed this year. I say, may you be transformed this year. I say, may you be transformed this year. I agree, it's the year of great catch. But for you to see the great catch, even Peter accepted to be transformed by Jesus. For him to see the great catch. Jesus told him, go to the deep. He told Jesus, we have been here the whole night, Jesus. We never caught anything. But because you have said, I will go. Because you have said, he accepted the transformation of the mind. Change is inevitable. Anyone who cannot change is a foolish man. Anyone who cannot change is a foolish woman. The Bible says it's only a fool who cannot make changes. Peter angekaa hapo sema usiku mzima hatukufanya kitu, hatukutega samaki. Yesu sikia, sirushi neti. But he accepted. Hatujashika kitu ndio. But by the transformation of the word of Jesus, nitarusha neti. May you be transformed. Great catch do not just come. If you want to see greatness in your business, you need to do something. You need to see greatness in your job. You need to do something. Go to school. Read books. Stop doing what you used to do. If you did something and it failed, drop it. May you be transformed in Jesus' name. I say, may you be transformed in Jesus' name. You must invest. Tell your neighbor, you must invest. Mwangalie mwingine mwambie, you must invest. Mungu angebariki Abraham akiwa na ushago wa kwao. Abraham angemess. Kuna watu hapa Mungu anataka kupea gari. Lakini mawazo yako lazima ibadilike. Maana wewe mawazo yako iko ukipata gari. Ha ha. He, ushago yenu itatambua. Until you are transformed here, that car will never come. There are people who are supposed to be living in their own houses. But the thinking you have, it cannot allow you. You are an enemy of you. You are like, if I get a house, so if watu wanakujaga kujaga kwa watu, I will come with an appointment. Mr. Kagi ujinga. Tu anatoka na huko kwenye ametoka ushago na vumbi na machawa zao. Tu anakuja kwangu mimi chanipata hiyo nyumba. The way you think, it's an enemy enough not to get a house. Be you transformed even when you come to church. Don't come to church because prophetess have announced an anointing service. There's nothing you'll never get. I saw someone asking me, prophetess, when do you break the pot? I want to attend. That person is coming because there is a pot that is going to be broken. When do you do one-on-one ministry? I want to come. He cannot come on Sunday. He wants that day that I'm doing one-on-one. He wants that day I am doing prophetic. Can you be transformed in your mind and come to church not because of prophetess Monica, not because of the topic being taught, not because of the declarations being given, not because there is a pot being broken, not because there is an anointing oil, not because there is a holy communion. You are coming to church because you are transformed and you are coming to church to get the word of God. Can you be transformed in your mind? Oh, hey. That is why you see people asking, prophetess, do you sell anointing oil? Do you sell holy water? people that are not transformed in their minds. They believe it's only holy water that can chase away demons. It's holy water that can chase away this sickness. Be transformed in your mind that you can take that anointing oil from the shop. Bless it and use it. You bless it and use it. You can take water and declare, this is the blood of Jesus. As you partake it, you are getting healed. Give it to your child and immediately the child will be healed. May you be transformed. I say, may you be transformed. Anyone that jumps from one church to another is because in their mind they are not transformed. When you are transformed, you will find yourself wiping the chairs in the church waiting for the service. That is what transformation do to a person. When you are transformed, you drive your V8, park it, enter church and sweep. When you are transformed, you will leave your position of work there. Come and wash the church. And you are a doctor. You are a surgeon. You are a banker. You leave it. And you come wash the church. That is what transformation do to people. But because you are not transformed, you are so bossy. Nataka kwanza niingie profetesa akisimama. Nasimamanga kitu 11. Una time saa zile profetesa naingia anasimama kwa altar. You are very far from transformation. Very far. In 2022, you have to decide to be transformed in your mind. If you have to see the great catch we are talking about. Transform your mind the way you think. This is the year you decide to serve the Lord. This is the year you decide to pray fast, even without me telling you. Can you tell your neighbor, let's decide, neighbor. Mwangalie neighbor, let's decide to be transformed. Another decision that you need to make if you have to see great catch. Be valuable in an exceptional way. Be valuable. Bring value to this world. 2022. Live in another realm. Shift your realm and go to the next realm. Tell your neighbor, be valuable in an exceptional way. See you too valuable, but in an exceptional way. Be excellent in what you do 2022. The area God called you, Francis, do it well. Ecclesiastes 9 verse 10. Whatever your hands finds to do, do it with all your might. 2022, if you want to see great catch, you have to be valuable in an exceptional way. You cannot afford to be just a Christian. You cannot just afford to be speaking in the same tongues from January to December. You cannot afford just to fast for one day or 7 days zile tunatangazanga za January and you are over. Be exceptional. Be excellent. Do it with everything. Whatever you do, read the Bible. Whatever you do, do well. For when you go to the grave, there will not be work. Or planning. Or knowledge. Or wisdom. Don't die with this knowledge. Don't die with knowledge and wisdom. Don't die with these ideas. Whatever you find to do, do it well. Tell your neighbor, whatever your hands find to do, do it well. Whatever your mind find to do it well. In an exceptional way. Add value to where you are. People do not just clap for you, they clap for something. People do not just applause you, they applause something they can see. People do not just celebrate people, they celebrate what they can see. Can you be celebrated this year? I say, can you be celebrated this year? Can you be that one person that you say, I refuse to be just comfortable? I refuse to do things madhongosto. I refuse to do things for the sake of doing them. If you are doing hair, you are a salonist, do that hair in a perfect way. Don't jump to every client because unataka kutengeneza watu wanane one day. Take what you know, this one, I can do it very perfectly, do with that. Kama ni kucha unatengenezanga, tengeneza kucha kusiwe na mtu mwingine ashaitengeneza kama hizo. Are we talking? Kama ni fashion, uko na nguo unauza. Uza kama hakuna cloth line nyingine ina exist. Kama wewe ni muimbaji, wewe waimbi. Muimbe. Acha kukula maneno. Imba kama wewe ni muimbaji, imba. Kuja practice ikiitanwa. Whatever you do, do well. Do with an excellent. If you are a waiter in a hotel, serve people well. Acha kwenda ukimwaga mwaga chai. Serve well. Once I was a waiter. And I was a favorable to so many people. Because I used to serve well. Serve it with an excellent. You know, serve it well. Lakini kuna watu tu wanafanyanga tu wafanye. Kuhunyerera. Kuhunyerera inaitwa nini na Kiswahili? Eh? Inaitwaje? Never seen people going to the farm. They wanalima, wakizika zingine, wakikata zingine. There are people doing like that in reality now in life. Do well. Na ndio maana nilikuambia, if you are hating, hate well until you are written somewhere in the book of Kumbukumbu. Ati, hey, wait. Martin hated his sister. Everybody knew about it in the entire town. You are written, you are remembered for what you are doing. So whatever you fight to do, do it until you are going to be remembered. Some of the people ask me, Prof, where do you get this energy? Energy to do everything. When you're preaching, energy. When you're talking, when you're walking, when you're advertising. Everything, energy. It's because I want to do well whatever I am doing. I want to do it well. If I'm selling a dress, I advertise it well. Oh, paka nagayuka nyuma. Do you want the details? Za kila mahali hiyo nguo. Do it well. If you are employed in an office, do your job well. Arrange the files well. Unajijua nyinyi last year venye mlifanya madhumusto. Uchange hii mwaka. Tell your neighbor, whatever you do, do well. Whatever you do, do well. People do not clap for nothing. You must show something for them to clap. You will not be clapped at it. Hey, but nowadays, by the way, I have come to realize people are clapping for mediocrity. Check who is clapping for you. If you are being clapped for by mediocres, tell them thank you, but pull up your socks. If you are being clapped by a champion, only one champion, well done, you are good to go. But nowadays, what is happening in our life? You find that the people that are doing nothing are the ones celebrated. Those that are doing something, they are the ones that are pinned down. Spirit of intimidating people. Spirit of humiliating others. I remove it in your life in Jesus' name. You find someone doing wrong. The watu wanapiga makofi. Lakini nijaanza saa yata na Yesu. Walisema, achilie ni nani? Barnabas. Mushike nani? Yesu. If we have to clap for you, show us the reason why we should clap. Simon, if we have to clap for you, give us the reason. Where God have called you apostle to work, you are an apostle. You are in charge. That is your field. Do it well. without looking. Nani ananiona? Nani ana clap? Nani ananicelebrate? Do it well until people will now have, they will not have choice but to celebrate you. If you are called to play this guitar, if you are called to play this, I thank God for Franco. Amecheza hii kitu mpaka imevunjika. Amecheza hii drum mpaka nanunulishwa vitu. Do it well. Igonge kabisa. Iraruke tununue ingine. Unanisikia? Whatever you find to do, do it well. Brancheza hii keyboard. Paka tusikie kana kwamba kuna keyboard ingine ulikuja nayo. Hii si ile yetu. Unajua, ni kama alikuja na keyboard mpya. Whatever you find, where God have placed you, Milka, where God placed you, do it. You serve people, you cook for people, cook good tea. Eka majani imejaa vizuri, sukari nzuri, maziwa wacha kuwekea ukua osops. Ekea ukua hapo karibu. Pikia watu chai mzuri. Najua vitu zimepanda bei, lakini pikia watu chai mzuri. Hata ukimwambia niongezee shilingi 10 kwa hiyo chai ataongeza. Do well, whatever you find to do. If you're an usher, usher well. Wacha kukuja hapa na mamuti. Monica, unanisikia? Paris, mko wapi? Usher wako kuja leo. Wacha kusimama hapa. Ukua umenuna. Ikaa ni sisi tukwambia ukuje utuwashe. Hapa. Kwambia hapa. Hello. Did I struggle to tell these people to move from there to here? I just asked them, requested them, and they came. Can you have a face of an usher? If you're doing protocol, protocol well. Don't protocol so that people can see you. Be valuable. And not just valuable, in an exceptional way. There must be something extraordinary in your service. Let there be something extraordinary in you that people admire. And if people clap for you for what you did, go to the next level. People do not clap twice for the same thing. Go to the next level. That is why you see some of us, we invest. You'll find me reading, listening to sermons, doing my studies. By the grace of God, I can come here and preach from John 1, 16. I can come here and preach Genesis 12. And God told Abraham, get out of your father's. Nani hubiri bila kusoma Bible. I can come here and preach. And Esther was a queen. She got favor in the eyes of God. Bila kuangalia Biblia. But I have to read and reread, revisit and revisit my notes. Not because I do not understand. It's because I want to be perfect at my job. I want to be perfect. That is why I will read this Bible. I have read it and I will read it again and again and again. I'll make notes. My notebooks. Nikikupatia notebooks zangu. Za sermons kuanzia siku ile nilianza kuhubiri. Zinaweza fungua bookshop. iPad yangu imejaa notes. Everywhere. I read, I make notes, I pray, I fast. I cannot just come here and preach and tell you, hey, after a while, nitaisha rather. The reason why you want to listen to me every day, after every day, after every day, it's because there is something exceptional when I am talking. Because I have worked to remove that thing. That is why you see preachers repeating themselves. This is our year. Our year of fulfillment. My case is urgent, January. My case is over, February. My case is new, March. Every, yani, rounding up, mahali pamoja. Si kwamba hajaitwa ameitwa, na amepakwa upako. Lakini, amekataa kukua valuable in an exceptional way. Hey, tell your neighbor, be valuable. Add value even to the people around you. The Bible says, popote Yesu alienda, alitenda mema. Popote unaenda, acha legacy. Uingie mahali hivyo, uache legacy. unapaswa nipe maji ya kunywa. Posa ameniletea maji. Ehe. Hiyo ilikuwa yangu ama ilikuwa ya kurudi nayo? Hiyo ilikuwa yangu ama ya kurudi nayo? Ulikuwa unafunika juu. Judi niletee maji ya kunywa. Niletee maji Judi. Judi ameniletea maji. Na amenifungulia funiko. Haya. Nicholas, nipe maji. Watu wananiletea maji. Na wako tu sawa. Na ananifungulia. Watu wananipea maji. Na ameniambia karibu. Judi hakuniambia. Aposo hakuniambia. Watu wameniletea maji. Aposto wameniletea ile ilikuwa kwa glass. Judi ameona hakuna glass. Ameniletea na chupa. Na akanifungulia. Nicholas akaona hakuna glass. Akaniletea na chupa. Akanifungulia na akaniambia karibu. Watu wameniletea maji ama wajaniletea? Wameniletea maji. Watu wameniletea. Na kila mtu na style yake. Nataka ni kuambia aje. Kuwa na style yako ya kufanya vitu. Na kama hii maji nimeletewa. Kuna hoteli tunaendaga hizi kubwa kubwa. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Mnataka tuende huku hizo ndogo ndio nini? Tunaendaga hizo kubwa kubwa. Unaletewa maji. Na anakuja na glass amebeba kwa tray. Anaekelea chini, anatoa glass, anaeka. Anafungua maji. Na anakuwekea. Akwambia welcome. Hiyo maji utakunywa? Kuna kwingine unaenda unaitisha maji. We, hey mai, una jagi. Naletewa maji. Naletewa na jag. Naekewa hapo. Na inarusha kwa hivyo. Inarusha kwa. Ndia glass. Na ni ya glass ya aluminium. Ama ya plastic. Nakuja. Inarusha kwa na style. Inakufikia mahali huko. Sasa, hao watu wote wametimiza haja ya moyo wako. Wamekupatia maji. Lakini style presentations matters a lot. Can I tell you? Kempinski, the same tea we take there, it is the same that is here. Hapa kwa barabara hapa. Kibanda. But presentation is what you buy. Can you be exceptional? That people say, kama si Simon anitengeneza, staki. Kama si Popo anitengeneza, staki. You have something extra. There's something that people see in you. Something that people love about you. That is what we are calling be valuable in an exceptional way. If you are dressing, dress well. Dress well. Do not dress half-half. Dress well. Semeni amen kwanza hapo kwa kudress. Kama ni kuvaa umeamua Miriam, siamue tu na uvae. Na Nicholas, anakuwa ameamua. Amua tu ngare. Na ngare. Na unaona Simon. Simon sijai muona kwa shaka. Hata akiwa kazini. Najua mahali anafanya kazi. Kama umeamua ngara ngara. Kama umeamua kutengeneza nywele. Tengeneza itengenezeke. Whatever you find to do, do well. Yes, Apostle. Tasikuwa nime notice. I tell you, you see now, what we amiamua 2022. Look at that. Kuna human hair kwa kichwa. Kawage dhaka we. Kama umeamua kuvaa nywele mzuri vaa. Wacha kuvaa alafu kesho unakuja hapa na matuta. Ujue umeinua level. Hakuna kushusha. Hakuna kushusha. Hallelujah. Ukiamua ni kuimba imba. Chochote umeamua kufanya, fanya. Tell your neighbor, nobody clap for you for something you have not done. So mwambie. Do something in your life. Milka, do something. Wacha kusema, by the grace of God, I declare this business, it will thrive. It is our year of great catch. My business, I speak the grace catch, great catch upon you. The grace of God is upon you. Arrange your business. So naombea hapo grace na business iko hivi. Mtu akikuja hajui aanze wapi, aone nini, aache nini. Sio grace itakupangia duka. Ni wewe na mikono yako. Sio neema, ni wewe na mikono yako. Sio grace itakupangia ndoa, ni wewe na mikono yako. Hello? Neema ipo ndio. Lakini wacheni kutumia neema vibaya. Neema kuna mahali inakataa kuapply. Wanako alikuwa ukuwa unakaa vizuri. Sasa anaingia kwa nyumba na kupata na kimotoki. Na t-shirt kubwa kukushinda. Hello? Mukitete alikuwa anaonaga hiyo figa. Kabiki kamoja, tuwili alikuwa anakuonaga hivyo. All of a sudden atijumezaa. Kwani kuzaa ni nini? Atujazaa sisi? Tunajua nilizaa recently. So, funga matiti. Weka pads za maziwa. Wacha kufungulia bwanako mlango. Maziwa ya nyonyo. Iko kila mahali, kila mahali, kila mahali. Ma punches. Ata he will understand. Understand what? Vaa vizuri. Najua uko na maziwa. Vaa pads za kushika maziwa vizuri. Na ukijua kukaribu kukuja, oga hiyo maziwa, spray yourself, spice up yourself, ukimkaribisha kwa nyumba. Hapo hakuna grace imetumika, ni wewe umetumia akili. Mam niombe, unajua kutoka nipate mtoto bwanangu ameanza kwenda nje, sijui hata nini. Ni wewe umejiachilia. Alikuwa amezoea kastana kazuri. Sasa anaingia kwa nyumba anapatana na Congestina. Mtu anakaa kupigana ngumi anytime. Umemfungia leso. Leso ndio umefunga leso. Na ni ile mzee, na alafu umevaa t-shirt hapo. Ya campaign. Tano tena. Ama Uhuruto. Na yeye ako upande huu mwingine unamvalia Uhuruto. Kiingia kwa nyumba mudi na haribika. Taske chap chap na taske ilikufa. Can you be exceptional in that marriage? Do something that others are not doing for your marriage to stand. In that relationship, do something that others are not doing. That man has been dating loose women that remove their panties anytime. Close yours. That is being exceptional. Wacha kwambie, of all the women I have dated, wewe ni mgumu. Ukuwe na katofauti na wale wote amedate. Kama mnaniangalia hivi. Mnashika hii mambo. Nawasaidia. 2022 staki tukivuka mwaka. Kila mtu analia. Nataka tukivuka mwaka uniambie, prophetess, I was transformed. I became valuable. I see the hand of God in my life. I've seen the hand of God in my life. Can you be valuable? Add value to you, to your neighbors, to your people, to the church of Christ, to where you work, to anyone that will come in contact with you. That is what I believe. Add value. Add value. Tell your neighbor, add value. Continue learning. Continue practicing. Because practice makes perfect. Don't say that I know how to play guitar. I know how to play keyboard, Brian. Practice ikikujua wewe waambie. Jueni relax na mjue sauti. Ninajua nitawachezea, ninajua venye inachezagwa. No, continue practicing even if you know. Me, I continue reading my notes. I continue reading my Bible and I know it. I know if you tell me to open about Joshua, I will open. If you tell me to open about Esther, I will open. If you tell me to open about Mordecai, if you told me to open about huyo mfalme alikula nyasi, nitafungua zote. Because I know where they are. But I continue reading my book. I continue learning. Pesa. Chini ya kiapo hisi ya buke yote. nirudisha hapa juu ile sadaka yangu ni mingi. Amen. Continue learning. Tell your neighbor, continue practicing. Continue learning. Continue asking questions. Asking is not foolishness. Learn. Desire to know things. Desire how to do that thing. Desire how to do an extraordinary thing in your life. Tell a neighbor next to you, if you don't ask, you'll never have answers. Find out how things are done. Find out how things are done. You cannot become exceptional if you are seated and believing in yourself. This is the year you need to explore. This is the year you need to go back to school if you have to. This is the year to read the books you have been saying I will read. This is the year to take yourself to some colleges, even some online classes. This is the year to learn something new that you never knew. Be exceptional. Tell your neighbor, be exceptional. Na uwezi ukafurahiwa na watu ukifanya ile kitu watu wote wanafanya. Fanya kitu tofauti. Tell your neighbor, do something different. Hallelujah. Do something? Yes. How do you do that something different? By learning, by practicing, by looking for answers, by looking for solutions, by looking for things, even in that plot, let them know you. You wakujue wewe. Wajua kuna yule mama. Unaona kuna yule mtu anajulikananga anajua kufanya kitu fulani. Hata ukikuwa hivyo shida iko wapi? Shida iko wapi? Kuna yule mtu anajulikana, huyu anajua kupika pilau. Ukimuita huyu pilau kwenu mnakula mzuri. Huyu anajua. Can you be an exception? Can you add value in the earth? Ni inama on the earth. Add value here on earth. Don't die with that book, write it. Don't die with those songs, sing them. Casually, mnashikwa ovyo ovyo. If you are cheating, cheat well. Bibi asijue. If you are cheating, cheat well with another lady that when your wife sees her, she will say, ah, you never let me down, my husband. You got taste. Cheat well if you are cheating. Be born again well if you are born again. Wacha maneno ya ujinga. Whatever you do, do well. Wacha mauongo yenye inaonekana ni mauongo. Kama ni kudanganya, danganya vizuri kuonekana ni kweli. Yeah. Whatever you do, do well. Kama ni kupika, pika vizuri. Wacha kupika mashakura. Kama ujui, kuna vitabu zaka watu kupika. Nunua vitabu. Kuna YouTube inaweza fundisha wewe kupika. Enda YouTube. Pika vizuri. Desire to cook even better this year. Okay, jeni mwambie, pika vizuri hii mwaka. Cha kupika mashakura. Ate mimi nikikula tu indomie nimeshiba. Na ukaliziwa. Pika hata kama uko bachara. Pika vizuri. Nunua vitabu jua kupika. Unaolewa, unashinda ukipia bwanako maragwe chapo. Maragwe mchere. Dengu chapo. Dengu mchere. Ugali. Na spinach, na sukuma. Do exceptional. Let him crave for your dinner. Anauliza atafika kwa nyumba sangapi maana kile umemwandalia. Kile hata kwa hoteli hawezi pata. Lakini shinda hapo na ugali na nini. Atakuja saa 8 akiwa amekula nyama choma na mabeshte wake. Afuanza kusema, hey, I think he's cheating. He's not cheating on you. Up your game. This year we are upping our games. If it is preaching, preach well. Apostle, if it is preaching, preach well. This is the year you will preach like never before. Start looking for notes. Make notes. Read your Bible today. Read your Bible. Tell God, give me knowledge and understanding about this word. When I stand there, I don't want to shout. I just want to bless people. Whatever you do. All right, let's see another decision you need to make this year. By the way, are you going to make those decisions? Are you going to change? Good. Hey, another decision. This one, I love it. And this one, I insist. Decide to have strategic relationships. We call it, in other words, social capital. social capital. Desire, decide, not desire, decide to have strategic relationships. Not just relationships. Not just relationship. No, but strategic. Be strategic with your friendship this year. Be very strategic. You better have only 5 people in your life than having 100 people that you are not going anywhere with them. Today, after the service, go and sit down, see your phone. If there is someone you never talked to last year, the whole year, delete them. Delete them. Nimesema? Delete them. Go on your Facebook. You have 5,000 people and they comment only 2. Remove them, my daughter. Remove them. If they request for a friendship, delete it. You cannot be having 3,000 people in your Facebook. You put a photo, very beautiful photo there. 5 likes, 3 from family members, na 2 comments. 24 hours. Na like yako pia iko hapo ndani. Delete them. Remove them. You need to have strategic relationships this year. Don't be a friend to everyone. Don't make one your friend. Love everybody. Pray for everybody. But choose wisely who you want to associate with this year. If in your list you don't have 5 people in your list of the phone, you don't have 5 people, Judy, that you can count on. Pray. If in your phone, I'm not talking about even money. In your phone, you don't have 5 people you can count on. You can count on in every area. You are in trouble. Very big trouble. Tell your neighbor for me, there are people that you need to drop 2022. Not because you hate them, but because you want to catch great. And those people, they will push you backward. They will never allow you to see greatness. There are people you need to drop in your life. There are people you need to drop in your life. You need to check again. Aiformat. Iformatiwe kama inafaa kuformatiwa. Relationship that helps you rise to the highest level. Relationship that brings out the best, not the bad. You know, there are people that you relate with, they bring out the bad part of you. They bring out the part ya kupiga makerere. Paka unajua haya, naeza pika makerere kumbe. Chukwa me bring out that part. Kuna watu naeza associate nao wa bring out the bad part of jealousy na chuki. Can you work with people this year that will only bring the good part of you from inside? 2022, we must decide. These are not resolutions. These are decisions. You have to decide. Tell your neighbor, decide. Have people that are adding value in your life. In all areas. People that you can pray with. People that you can pray with. Pray. Tell God, I want a true friend. Tell God, I want a true friend that I can talk. And I usually teach you, and I told you another day, you need 3 categories of relationships in your life. Those that look up on you. Those that are in your level, you can talk anything with them. You can tell them anything. You can tell them whatever you feel without them judging you. And those that you look up to, you need 3 categories of relationship this year. And I release them to you in Jesus' name. I release them to you in Jesus' name. I release people that will add value in your life. People that will bring out the good in you. People that will drive you into the ministry. People that will drive you into business. People that will drive you in corporate world. People that will drive you in your ideas that you carry. In where God has called you. May God bring them in your life in Jesus' name. You need covenant relationships. Not based on emotions. Not based on feelings, based on covenant of the word of God. emotions last year. This year, tell God, I don't want to have relationship. Ati ukisikia kikitu, umeambiwa umchukie, unamchukia. That is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about relationship that are grounded. Relationship like that of Jonathan and David. The Bible says in 1 Samuel, give us 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 18 verse 1. Relationship that will add value in your life. Relationship that will carry you to the next level. Don't relate with people, all of them in the same level. People are different. Relate in dimensions. The Bible says, after David had finished talking with Saul, he met Jonathan, the king's son. There was an immediate bond of love between them, and they became the best of friends. Jonathan and David, they had a bond that had a covenant. If you read in 2 Samuel, the Bible says, when David wanted to bless the house of Saul, he asked, for the sake of Jonathan, is there anyone remaining here? I may show kindness. Why? Because he was having valuable covenant relationship with the father. Relationships are very, very important because they touch even your generations. Because of the relationship of Jonathan and David, the son of Jonathan was blessed. Alikuwa anaitwa nani son of Jonathan? Mephibosheth. He was lame. He was not walking. He was in Lodba, somewhere very bad. And he was a grandson of a king. David remembered the covenant. There are people that you need this year, that you need to have covenants in relationships, that we are going to help one another in this business na hakuna kurushana. We are going to help one another in this and hakuna kurushana. Relationship that are trustworthy. Relationship that do not have vitu zingine na hapo nyuma. Relationship that are not attached on something, but pure relationships. Pure. Tell your neighbor for me, neighbor. Neighbor. Are you hearing what prophetess is saying? Enda ufute watu. Watoe kwa Facebook yako. Watoe kwa simu yako. Mwambie watoe. Simwambie watoe. 2 Samuel 9 verse 1. Chatuone venye relationship ya Jonathan and David did. The Bible say, one day, David asked, let's read together. Who can show kindness for Jonathan's sake? Because Jonathan and David had a relationship that was adding value in their lives. When Jonathan died, David took over his house. Have people that can, you know, lay down their lives for you. People that can leave what they are doing, they run and come kukuokoa wewe. People that can send you money without asking you, when are you paying back? People you tell, I am going through this and this. Anakwambia, my sister, can we enter fasting tomorrow? I am praying with you. People you say, this is what is happening in my life. In the next 15 minutes, they are in your house. They leave what they are doing because of you. If you don't have such people, hata kama ni wawili ama watatu, you need to pray. Tell God, Father, I pray for strategic relationships this year. In Jesus' name. And do not, you know, do not put all your friends or the relationships that God is going to give you 2022 in the same basket. Everybody, they are called in different way to become a blessing to you. Don't communicate the same honor to everyone. There are people that they are there spiritually. There are people that are there to help you spiritually. There are people that are there to help you financially. There are people that are there to help you in business. There are people that are there to help you in ideas. Others are there to help you in advices. Others are there to help you in one way or another. So, know your friends. Know your friends. Know your friends. Wacha kuweka kazi yao ni nini kwa maisha yako. Mary. Mary yako. Nani alikuwa kununua kalamu? I want to show you an example. Sitaki kalamu, nikataka mwenye alikuwa kununua kalamu. Mary, kuja. Kwa duka kimbia ununulie kitu. Inaitwa queen cake, unilete. Ama keki yoyote unilete. Taka nifundishe watu kitu. Ndio 2022 uamue. Tunaamua. Tunaamua. Quickly. You cannot relate to your friends in the same way. Daunga kama tatu, ama tano kulingana na vile. Haya, maziwa. Maziwa. Ndoo moja. Glass ngapi? One glass. Sukari. Nusu kikombe. Chumvi. Chumvi. Pinch. Aya. Vanilla essence of flavor. One teaspoon. Sini ukweli? Nini ingine mulisema? Baking. Baking. Simu nijibu. Kajiko kale kadogo, sindio? Nini ingine mulisema? Mayai. Tatu. Sio kumi. Tatu. Hizo vitu zote ziko kwa hii keki. Zote. Lakini kila kitu imeplay pati yake. Na hakuna kitu imewekwa nyingi kushinda vile inafaa kuwekwa. Unga ndio base ishikanisha hii keki. Ndio inafaa kuwa mingi. Kuna watu wako hivyo maishani mwako. Wao ni unga. Wengine ni baking. Ukieka vijiko mbili zile kubwa, watatoboa maisha yako. Wengine ni chumvi. Ukipika chakula ya familia yako, unaekaga chumvi inatoshana aje? For example, 5 people in the family. I believe ni kijiko moja, or even less. Na ukieka vijiko tatu, haitakulika. Kuna watu ni chumvi, wacha kuwaleta sana maisha ni mwako. Wataharibu. Nimekurulia. Unahitaji tu, kuna watu tu unahitaji ka pinch kao in your life. Hao ni wale wa mzoeani. Wako huko. But they are very valuable. Without them there is no sweetness. But wako wapi? Wako wapi? Kuna wengine ni ginger. Tunapika kila kitu na ginger. Wengine ni majani, utawahitaji siku ya chai. Ukiwaweka kwa mchere wataharibu. So hao unachomwaga wakati unapika chai. Kuna hao ni wa season fulani. Ukiwaleta kwa maisha yako ya kila siku mnakosana. You need to be strategic with relationships this 2022. You need to be. Wengine ni roiko. Ukiweka kwa chai, wanaharibu chai. So hao unawahitaji wakati unapika beef. Waongeze utamu kwa hiyo chakula. Lakini ukiweka kwa uji, wataharibu uji. Haitakunyuka, uji iko na roiko. So I want to tell you, can you differentiate the people God is going to bring in your life? Differentiate their roles in your life. Differentiate their roles in your life, because not everyone that is needed to be seen on a daily basis. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Until there, do we get what I wanted to ask for this, because najua hii haitatoka kwa akili zenu. You know there are things that we do practically, because hii haitatoka. Itaifutika, utakuwa unaona queen cake unakumbuka. Ukiona keki unakumbuka inakusongesha mbele. So there are people that you need to drop. Kudrop. Wengine ni kudrop. Wengine una drop kabisa. kabisa kabisa mnaonana mnaonana wakati huko kwa harusi za wenyewe na huko hi hi are you okay yes I'm okay good good bye bye god bless hivyo na hamjakosana mko sawa wengine unahitaji every day because you cannot live without them they are the base of your life wengine unahitaji kuongea na wao every week because they are the salt and you need them in your food every day lakini kadogo ukieka mingi unaroria tell your neighbor for me neighbor be strategic this year with your relationships be very strategic do not just enter in relationships with people friendship with people that are not adding any value in your life and do not place everyone everywhere know who to place here and who to place there are people when they are far your relationship with them and friendship is so good when they come close it ends there are people when they are far you are out of their mind so you need to be close to them for you to be able to work with them hallelujah there are people that God will bring in your life when he brings in your life you don't sleep with them immediately you sleep with them as a friend they leave you they were meant to come to be friends not husband or wife when you have no romantic relationship with them you are super they are okay you are helping one another immediately you allow romance to enter in that friendship the value of that person the value of you na ni mtu alikuwa kusaidia tell your neighbor neighbor know what to do with people this year have strategic relationships we call it social capital there must be somebody in your life that will help you and most of this capital I call them destiny helpers they come sometimes in a place of destiny helpers they bring services of a destiny helper they help you to do something that you cannot do alone this cake cannot become a cake without flour can never become a cake without milk without the ingredients it needed all of them together to be added to make a cake you too there are people that you need in your life to be complete like this cake and you need to know who are they all chokers in your life remove them all mediocres in your life remove them people that are not adding value remove them people that are bringing moshene remove them wao ndio najua uhuru alikuwa wapi ruto alikuwa wapi alitukana na nani alifanywa nini wao ndio bbc remove them in your life you don't need them you have a tv at your home and you have a phone if you want to google you can google where uhuru was kwenda mishene 100,000 hello yes preserve them for that day that you want to start a business and you go to them and tell them my brother you know what you know I'm not lazy if I do business I know I'll make it and I need 100,000 but if you ask them for 500 every day 1,000 every day 200 every day sina credo itumie sina food leo tunalala nja when you need 100,000 from them you will not even have guts to ask them their grace will not be there preserve them preserve them don't take advantage of them don't take advantage of people don't take advantage of people if people are so good to you don't see as if it is kawaida it is not kawaida preserve people for a day that you need them wacha kushindaka kwa huyo mtu usiku mchana asubuhi lazima umuone usiku mchana asubuhi wakati utakuwa na kitu unamhitajia ya muhimu utampata so take care of your relationships take care of your friendships this year be intentional to look for valuable friendships to look for valuable relationships tell your neighbor be intentional ya mwisho ndio tufunge decide to be spiritually empowered decide to be spiritually empowered. Desire genuine anointing 2022. Stop jumping from one anointing to another. Desire to see Jesus at work in your life. Desire to grow in the spiritual realm. Desire to see God manifesting in your life. Desire genuine power. Desire spiritual growth. Ile ya kwanza nilisema, decide to do what? To be serious with God. Now this is yours. Decide to grow you. You as a person, desire to grow spiritually. Desire to pray. Desire to fast. Desire to read. Desire to see work, you are, the anointing inside of you working. Desire to see Jesus at work in your life. Ati kwamba unaweza itwa hapo na neighbor kwambia nasikianga ukiomba kuja uombe mtoto wangu naona vile anafanya ni kama anataka kukufa. You go there and you say, by the power given to me by God, I command every sickness out of this boy, and the boy rise. Desire to grow spiritually, to be empowered spiritually. Hello, you as a person, I'm not talking about coming to church, I'm not talking about, you know, coming to the fellowship. I'm saying, you as a person, you be intentional of growing spiritually. 2022. Do you want to see great catch? Church, do you want to see great catch? You need to be on another level in the spiritual realm. Lazima ukubali ku grow. Desire to grow to a level that you have never been. Come on, you are not talking in tongues. Desire that January will not end without being filled by the Holy Ghost. You are not able to pray. Even last year, you never prayed the 21 days. Desire that this year, we are starting our prayers on Sunday, coming Sunday. That this year, determined, be intentional. You will enter this fasting and you will do it. Desire. Desire, you will grow. Your inside will grow. When you are walking, you are talking Jesus. When you are eating, you are eating. You are talking Jesus. When you are driving a car, you are talking Jesus. That is when you know you have grown in the spiritual realm. The Bible says, if you are eating or drinking or whatever you are doing, do it for the glory of God. Grow spiritually. If you're walking on the road, you speak in tongues on that road. You pray as you walk. You pray as you eat. You pray as you shower. You pray as you sleep. You pray as you drive a car. You grow. You are intimate with God. Let it go to the next level. That you feel the Holy Spirit as you walk. You feel the Holy Ghost has come down. As you walk, without even praying, you feel Him. He has come down. Desire to have an intimate relationship with God. Desire to grow in the spiritual realm. You grow to a level you cannot be lied by prophets of doom. You cannot be scammed. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Angalia jina mwambie grow. You personal, you. I'm not talking about PCC. I'm saying about you on a personal level. Grow. Grow to the next level. Last year, you know the level you were with God. Why don't you desire to lift that level this year? And you only need to do some few things for you to grow spiritually. To pray. To fast. Read your Bible. Talk about the work of God. Talk about God. Replace those many words with the word of God. Seek God. You don't need even to go to heaven. You need just to love God and to do what He wants you to do for you to grow. When you grow, you will not get late to church. When you grow, you will not give like you used to give. Your giving will change. When you grow in the spiritual realm, spiritually you are empowered. Spiritually you are grown. You will not come to church with shift and seasons. You will not talk ill and evil about the men and the women of God, because you grow to the level that you are so busy with God, you have no time to talk with mediocrity. You have no time to backbite. You have no time to waste. Can you get to the next level? Tell your neighbor, in the spiritual realm, my neighbor, go to the next level. If you want to see great catch, go to the next level. Rise on your feet.